Today, it is all about forex market and its structure. Okay. Have you gone through financial markets?
Yes, sir.
What type of markets are there?
So primary market, secondary market, money market, capital market, physical market, financial market, and
when we say market, financial market, what do you have?
So in that, money market, capital market, forex market, derivative markets, and international finance market.
Good. Financial markets, when you say equity market, debt market, derivatives market, money market, forex market. Okay. Did you go through equity market, debt market, money market, and other markets? Anyone? I think you already had a course on that. It already started. I also shared a PPT on that today. Can anyone tell what is an equity market?
Market where the shares are traded through exchange, sir. It is a market.
Yeah, good. I agree. What Jagdish said is right. What do you say, others? So what is an exchange, Jagdish? You said where shares are traded on an exchange, you said, right? So what is an exchange? Can anyone help Jagdish?
Exchange is nothing but where the... Suppose, sir, I can give an example, sir. For suppose a company is there, sir, they want to raise up their capital. What they want to do, they should issue the shares to the public through IPOs. Then they want to get the capital, sir. It is a form of exchange, sir.
Okay, good. Anyone else can elaborate Jagdish or add what Jagdish said or give any other point? What is an equity market?
Sir, buying and selling of shares.
Good. Agreed. Kamalakshi?
Yes, sir.
Go on.
So it's like buying and selling of equity shares within a company. If they want the capital, they issue the equity shares. So that is equity market.
Okay, good. Anyone else? Okay. Jagdish used the word exchange. Okay, when I'm asking him exchange, he clearly told... When I asked you equity market, he used the word exchange. Okay. It is buying and selling of shares in exchange, he told. Okay. So exchange refers to stock exchange. Okay. Bombay Stock Exchange, National Stock Exchange, regional stock exchanges like Hyderabad Stock Exchange, Bangalore Stock Exchange, Cochin Stock Exchange, Ahmedabad Stock Exchange, and so on. New Delhi Stock Exchange, Calcutta Stock Exchange, Madras Stock Exchange. So, we are exchanging shares, equity shares. So, we call it as equity market. Similarly, debt market is also existing in exchanges, the stock exchanges. Okay, you can call them as securities exchange. Instead of stock, even derivatives are also are getting traded or exchanged there in BSE, NSE. Fine. So when we look at foreign exchange market, okay, you can call it as foreign currency market, foreign exchange market, forex market, or international currency market. Maybe that's what Meghna was trying to refer when I asked her, what do you mean by international finance market? Okay. Let us discuss with the PPT we had. Okay. Foreign exchange market and its structure. Okay. So, forex market is a market for domestic currency in exchange to foreign exchange, foreign currency. Foreign exchange market is a market where domestic currency, you say in India, Indian currency and foreign currencies exchange takes place. Not only that, foreign exchange market is also the market for any two different foreign currencies, US dollar, sterling pound, British pound. Okay, so this way, if there is any market where foreign currency is involved and it is exchanged with domestic currency or any other foreign currency, you call it as foreign exchange market or forex market. So I think Jagdish introduced equity market by using the word exchange. Okay, but unlike equity market, it has a different nature. What is that? Let us see. Electronic market, nowadays all the markets are electronic, okay? But since its inception in 60s 70s 80s 90s, forex market has been electronic, not just now, okay? Geographical dispersal, so globe is the base for it. It is not limited to India, USA or UK. The currency exchange rates, the currency values keep on changing with the global changes. It has a geographical spread. Then when you're talking about exchange of foreign currency, it is the exchange of purchasing power. We discussed about purchasing power parity theory. You remember, any one of you? The previous session we discussed about interest rate parity and purchasing power parity. So what did we consider in purchase power parity?
So Pavan is saying that it is measurement of prices of different currencies
and countries.
Sorry, country.
What is the base? You are defining foreign exchange. I am asking you purchase power parity.
So purchasing power parity says that exchange rate between the two currencies are in equilibrium when the purchasing power is same, or let's say the inflation in that country is same.
That's it. I was looking for that. Correct. Exactly correct. Who is this? I can't see you.
So Asha.
Yeah, Asha. Thank you. Based on purchasing power, that is inflation, exchange rate between two countries is fixed. Okay. That you call it as purchase power parity theory. Yeah. Can you tell me what does interest rate parity theory say? Asha, can you try?
So, as per interest rate parity theory, exchange rate between the two countries or currency depends upon the rate of interest of the countries.
Good. Thank you. So, in the previous session, we discussed about exchange rate of Russian ruble and Indian rupee based on inflation and interest rate. So, forex market is all about exchanging the foreign currencies based on the purchasing power which gets transferred through the value of one currency to the other. Then presence of intermediaries, so it's mandatory. Without intermediaries, it is not possible. Then provision for credit in these markets, it is there since beginning. Like, unlike stock markets, which is optional and introduced later, it is there. Omnipresent throughout the world, the markets are on and the currencies get traded. And there is no specific timing and it is on for 24 hours. Court system is a little different when you say stock prices, stock market, two digits after the decimal are considered. But whereas in the case of forex market, four digits after the decimal are considered. And bid ask spreads are very narrow. Okay. Can any one of you tell me what is the forex rate, exchange rate between INR and USD?
Sir, today it is 0.05%, sir.
So 1 rupee is 0.05%,
sir.
Percentage 0.05. 0.05 rupee. You are giving the change in exchange value or you are giving the exchange rate, Rajshekar? I want the exchange rate. $1 how many rupees? 1 rupee how many dollars?
Sir, $1 equal to 73.73 paisa, sir.
If you convert that into inverse quote, that is 1 divided by 73.74, you will get 1 rupee is equal to how many dollars? As simple as that. So, typical to any other financial market, it has brokers, buyers, sellers, liquidity providers, regulators. It is quite common. Then this is something interesting. Intermediaries, they have this kind of a role as market makers and STP and ASN forms. Okay. So, of course, electronic communications network is there. STP is also there, but that is also through a broker or dealer. In the forex market, we call them as dealer. Market maker, like we have NEFT or ODIN in NSE and BSE, like that in forex market we have ECN and STP, which is very, it is an electronic trading platform. Okay. Market makers, they make the market, they are everything for the market. American markets, even stock markets, they do that. New York Stock Exchange, they have that. They give, if for example, if you want to buy, will you give your bid or ask? Can anyone? If you want to buy a share, will you give bid or ask? Okay, all the bids are buying prices. All the ask are selling prices. The market makers, they have to give both bid and ask. They want to provide liquidity. They make the market. They want to keep the market active. That's how they are known as market makers. Then I just categorized the buyers and sellers in forex market. Based on need, we have government borrowings, giving donations, repaying the loans, paying interest or debt services. Then exporters, they sell their goods outside India. Importers, they buy goods outside India. Tourists and travelers. And foreigners, they come for some education or to give some voluntary service for NGOs or for some other reasons, they visit India. So that is mandatory to carry foreign currency. Then based on some money motive, you know, they want to make money. Okay, they want to become rich. People like speculators, traders, hedgers, investors. Okay, hedger, they doesn't want to make money. They want to manage the risk. Okay, I think in your other subject, you have a derivatives market. There you will understand that. Okay, in our course, other unit also, we have that. I will explain you foreign currency derivatives. I will explain you at the time. So speculators, traders, investors, even arbitragers. You know arbitrager? You know speculator? You know trader? You know investor? Either you ask me, or you tell me. How do I know? Okay, so based on the needs.
Speculators.
Yeah. Which one?
Speculators, sir.
Speculator, they anticipate the price to Jagadish, how much you told today? 73.74?
Yes, sir. 73.73.
So 73.73 is today's exchange rate between Indian rupee and dollar. So I'm speculating for some reason. Let it be new coronavirus or some other thing. I'm expecting the exchange rate to go up to say 75. So I try to buy today itself. I keep on buying till I get exhausted with my money. That is speculation. Okay. Then traders. Traders, they buy and sell in the same day. So buy for low price, sell for high price. Buy for, sell for high price and later close the trade for low price. They keep on selling till they get some profit.
Sir, they will call as intraday sellers also. intraday traders also, no?
Traders, the difference between traders and speculators are, speculators are, see, for example, I feel petrol price, I don't know how much is the per liter petrol price right now. I'm speculating petrol prices will go up because of the global happenings. What I do, I fill my fuel tank of my car, two wheelers and everything, and I try to store extra more. Okay, I don't want to make money out of it. I want to get advantage by buying in advance. That is speculation. Okay, whereas traders, intraday or within 2 days or 1 week or 1 month, for short term they want to make money. Buy today, sell tomorrow. Buy today, sell today. Intraday trading. That kind of traders are also there, as Jagdish was saying. And investors, they want to make money in the long term. Okay? So I will buy, I have plans to move to US. Maybe after 5 years or 10 years. So I keep on accumulating dollars from now itself. I'm a kind of investor who is looking at, it is a need, but is also a kind of investor. Okay, so hedging, I will tell you, we have many in the next sessions. It is a risk management tool protecting foreign currencies. Then, as I told you, there are some intermediaries. Yeah, somewhere here I mentioned. Yeah, liquidity providers, investment banks, or commercial banks, they do that. Popular banks in forex markets, this is the list. Okay. Then in any country, unless until there is no regulation, people will not listen to you. Okay. So central bank in India, RBI, then government sponsored organizations like FEDAI or some other bodies, then constitutional rules and regulations, FERA, FEMA in India we have. So these people are active in regulating and monitoring foreign exchange market or foreign currency market. This is something interesting. Unlike equity or debt or derivatives market, forex market is of three tier. One is the market for RBA and authorized dealers. Okay, authorized dealers means it could be banks or any other company like software companies. Software companies, they have 100% exports. They deal heavily with foreign currency. So they register themselves as dealers with RBI. So all the commercial, need not be all the banks, most of the banks are dealers with RBI. So banks or other companies, you can call them as authorized dealers. The dealings between RBI, Central Bank of India, Reserve Bank of India, is known as tier one market. And tier two market, the dealings between banks and banks are among authorized dealers. I think there is an error, please correct it. It is tier three market. It is the banks and retail. If you are going for higher studies to US or UK or Australia, or if you are going on tourism for Europe or Asia, South Asia, you're going to Sri Lanka or somewhere, you need foreign currency. In that case, either me or you or anyone, we have to approach banks. So authorized dealer and retail, this is tier three market. Then spot market, forward market, swap market. I think this happens with any kind of financial markets. Let me see, I have the explanation for this or not. Yeah, I have the explanation. So spot market is the base for any market. There's a cash market. Equity market we have today, trading happening today, then the spot market, there's a cash market. Based on that, if there are any derivatives, we call them as derivative market for that currency. You have equity derivatives based on equity market. You have forex derivative markets based on forex markets. So, but for any derivative market, underlying base is the spot market, okay? So like that, you have forward market, futures market, options market, and swaps. Quickly, I'll tell you about it. And whatever the forex market we are talking about, buying the US dollar by paying 73 rupees 74 pice, that is happens in spot market, whether I'm buying from a bank or a bank buying from a bank, or a bank from buying from an RBA, it is spot market. Okay. Then forward market, this happens with people who are importing and exporting. Okay. And here, if market today is 73 plus or close to 74, I'm an exporter. I exported $100,000 worth of products. Then I'm expecting 73,74,000 rupees after 1 month, say. But I'm not sure whether price will go up or it will come down. Then what I will do is I will enter into an agreement with some person, bank or any other person, so that he or she will pay me exactly 73.74 per dollar as currency with $100,000 after 1 month. So that becomes a forward agreement between me and another person or institution. This is part of hedging or risk management to fix, to manage foreign currency exchange rate volatility. For example, if our Indian rupee with dollar is fixed forever, then you don't see either forward market or future market or swap, nothing is there. Because exchange rates change every day, every minute, we have a forward market. Okay? Then swap market means it happens with the loans. Okay? Dollar currency loans are swapped with pound, sterling pound denominated loans or euro dollar denominated loan. That is one way of looking at that. Okay, I think that's what I was telling you. Simultaneous purchase and sale of two different currencies of identical amounts or one currency with two different value dates. Okay, I gave you one example of loans. Another example is there is 1 month forward, 2 month forward, 3 month forward, even future also. And there is another market for swap. 1 month future is swapped for 3 months forward. That is a swap. Swap means exchanging the contracts. That is one way. Same is the currency. $1 and how many rupees? For 1 month is swapped with 3 months. That is one way of looking at swap. Another way is Indian rupee versus dollar is swapped with Indian rupee with euro dollar. These kind of contracts do exist. So different currencies contracts are swapped, or same currency with different expiry dates are swapped. Okay, so this we discuss more in foreign currency risk management when we talk about foreign currency exposure. Okay, so spot market, forward market, swap market. Swap means exchanging the contracts. So within less time, we did the best. If you still have any question, you please ask me quickly. Any questions? If you don't have questions, I have questions for you. What do you say, which one you want? Our time is up. So will you answer my questions? Or shall I answer your questions? Choice is yours. What's the difference between forward market and swap market? Okay, I will give you one more question. What's the difference between equity market and forex market?
So forex market is nothing but exchanging of domestic currency with other foreign exchange currencies, sir.
Okay.
Already we spoken about the equity market at beginning of the class. Next, you said that.
What is exchanged in equity market, Jagadish?
Sir. So now I am visible,
exchange,
sir.
Exchange of shares, sir.
Exchange of?
Buying and selling of shares.
What is exchange? I want to know that. What is exchange in equity market? You went to a shop and buy something, that fellow is selling you something. So what is exchange there?
Commodity and money.
That's it. Who said that?
Asha sir.
In equity market, equity shares are exchanged with money. As simple as that. Is haath se paisa lo, us haath se shares do. Exchange. Okay? That is stock exchange, equity exchange in equity markets. But in foreign currency markets, what happens? Rupee is exchanged with dollar. You give rupee, take dollar. Exchange is over. Okay? So when you buy something in a shop, so how much money, how many units of the product, you will discuss, you will negotiate, you will bargain. Then only exchange happens. Same is the case with equity share. You have money, you have seller. Through bid and ask system, you negotiate, then money and shares are transferred, exchanged. Same is the case with foreign currency market. US dollar, Indian rupee. $1, how many rupees? There is a market. You look for that. If you are not getting the right price, you'll go away. And this fellow wants to sell dollars. If there is no right price, go away. And both of them agree. They have a deal. Then dollar is getting exchanged with rupee at a specified exchange rate, as Jagadish told, 73.74. Okay. So further, if there are no questions, we'll stop it for the day. Thank you. See you on Friday first session. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.